Hey Chelsea. Your mother and I are going to be on vacation to New York for a few days, and not only it's gonna be me and your mother going, but Hatsune Miku is going with us.
And before you say anything, I know you really want to go to the New York with us, but the reason why you're gonna be at home is because me and your father want to spend some time with Hatsune Miku, and we just want to have some alone time with her.
So, you will be having a babysitter to watch you.
Who isn't gonna be? Is Grandma and Grandpa gonna babysit me?
Unfortunately, no. They have other things to do.
Well, I hope Wubsy babysits me.
Sorry, Chelsea, but he also has other things to do.
Oh. So, who isn't gonna be?
Your babysitter will be Serene Basil.
Wait, what? Serene Basil will be my babysitter for a few days? Why did you hire her?
Well, we are aware of how dangerous Serene can be when she is angry or when she is out of control during some fights. But we have a reason on why we trust her to look after you. Serene Basil has a kingdom, and she is the queen of that kingdom. Your mother and I have visited her kingdom more than once and saw how nicely she treats her minions and brother.
And according to her brother, Book Glitter, she is very kind to animals and loves taking care of them. We have seen how kind she is towards her pets.
Oh, I see.
Anyways, we made breakfast for you, and it's on the dinner table right now. Serene should be coming over in a few minutes.
If you behave yourself while Serene is babysitting you during the time we are in New York City, then we will take you to Dave and Buster's. Do you understand?
Yes, Mom and Dad. I understand. I will try my best to behave while Serene is babysitting me.
Good. Anyways, as we said before, your breakfast is on the table. We will be leaving to go to New York City now. We'll see you when we get back. Farewell, Chelsea.
Bye, Mom and Dad. Well, now that my parents are on vacation, it's time to eat breakfast and wait for my babysitter. All right, I'm done with my breakfast. Now it's time to put this in the sink. Okay, now I'll wait for my babysitter to get here. I hope she arrives here soon. In the meantime, I'll go ahead and play some games on my computer. Oh, come on. What is taking my babysitter so long to get here? Why is she so late? You know what? That's it. I suppose it's time I teach her a lesson she will never forget, and I know exactly what I'm going to do to get her for being late. Ha ha ha. I can't wait to see my babysitter fall for this. This is what she gets for being late.
Okay, I'm here. That sure was a long session of training and magic. Anyways, time to go inside and take care of Chelsea while Bowser Jr. and Pom Pom are gone. So Chelsea just decided to leave the door partly open and put a teddy bear on top of the door just so that I could get pranked. Huh? All of this because I am late. Hep, nice try, Chelsea. Although I didn't expect you to do this just because I'm late, I've already figured out this trick. You'll have to do better than that.
Oh man, I can't wait to see my babysitter fall for the trick I pulled.
Think again, Chelsea. You really think I would fall for that?
What the heck? How did you get in here? I didn't see you get hit by the teddy bear when you got here.
Did you already forget about my abilities to teleport and do magic? And you're doing this prank just because I'm late, huh?
Okay, you got me there. Yes, I admit that I forgot about your magic abilities. I also admit that I tried doing this prank on you just so you could learn your lesson on being late. Why are you late anyway, Serene?
Well, Chelsea, I'm sorry for being late. But the reason why I arrived late is because of a long training and magic session I needed to attend to.
Oh, I see.
Anyways, as you already know, my name is Serene Basil, and I'll be taking care of you while you, your parents are in New York City with Hatsune Miku. Chelsea, what do you want to do?
I don't know. Maybe we could play some video games in my room?
Okay, that sounds good. But we will only play the ones that are appropriate for both of us to play. I see. So you got a Nintendo Switch, huh?
Yes, I do. You said that we should play games that are appropriate for us to play, but what game do you want to play with me?
Well, I'm not entirely sure. These games seem to be good. I see that the games you have are Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, Kirby's Return to Dreamland Deluxe, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and South Park, The Fractured But Whole. Are you kidding me? Chelsea, why do you have the South Park, The Fractured But Whole game for the Nintendo Switch? That game is rated M, and you are far too young to be playing this game. I want you to tell me the truth right now, Chelsea. Who bought the South Park, The Fractured But Whole game for you while you are still too young to play that game?
It was my dad. My father bought the South Park, The Fractured But Whole game for me because Dark Bowser forced him to do that.
Bowser Jr. bought this game for you. I thought he was better than this. I will need to have a serious talk with your parents about this when they get back. Anyways, let's play the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe game.
Thanks for playing video games with me, Serene. I had a lot of fun gaming with you.
No problem, Chelsea. I may have beaten you a couple times in this game, but you have beaten me a few times in this game as well. Anyways, what do you want to do next?
Hey, Serene. Can we play hide and seek? I play this game a lot with my friends.
Sure. Although I might not be entirely familiar with this game, I have played it a couple times before. You go ahead and hide somewhere, and I'll try my best to find you.
Okay.
15, 14, 13, 12. Time's up. Ready or not, here I come, Chelsea.
Oh my gosh, I pranked you so hard, Serene.
When
you're
feeling lonely, lost and lonely, seems like those dark skies are falling.
Oh my gosh, Chelsea. Why in the world would you slam a pie into my face like that? Now I need to go into the bathroom to wash my face so that all of this comes off. I'll be right back. Go ahead and do something else while I'm gone. Damn, I've got to admit, Chelsea did get me good on that prank. Overall, she's doing okay in behaving while I'm babysitting her, but I need to speak to Bowser Jr. and Pom Pom. I'll do that after they get back from New York City. But right now, I'm going to go ahead and make something for lunch. I brought my brother's cookbook with me anyways. Let's go. Chelsea, I'm going to the kitchen to make lunch for both of us to eat. I have a cookbook with me, so I want you to read it and decide on what you want to eat.
So this is one of Book Glitter's cookbooks, huh? Well, let's see what recipes this book has that is good. I need some time to decide for myself about what I want for lunch. I've looked through the entire cookbook, and I decided that I want Persian fried fish, but the refrigerator might not have all of the ingredients that Serene needs to make that. I'll just tell her that I want Persian fried fish anyways and see if the fridge has all of the ingredients for that recipe. Serene? I read your brother's cookbook, and I've decided on what I want for lunch.
Well, what would you like to have for lunch, Chelsea?
I decided that I want Persian fried fish for lunch. Could you check the refrigerator to see if there are enough ingredients to make that recipe?
Okay, I'll check.
Thanks for cooking lunch for us today, Serene. I'm hoping that this recipe you made for us will taste good.
So do I, Chelsea. Now let's eat.
That recipe was so delicious. Your cooking skills are very good, Serene.
Well, I wouldn't say that I'm as skilled in cooking as my brother is, but thank you for the compliment, Chelsea. Anyways, I'm going to go wash the dishes. Oh, I'm getting a phone call. I'll pick it up and see who is calling me. Hello, who is this?
Hello there, Serene. This is Hanzo. How are you doing?
Things are going well, sweetie. What about you? And why are you calling me at this time?
I'm glad you're okay, honey. I'm also doing fine. Anyways, Serene, I'm calling to ask you if you would like to go to a movie theater to see the Super Mario Bros. Movie with me. Are you available?
As much as I would like to go on a date with you, Hanzo, I'm afraid I can't go to the movie theater with you.
Huh. Why is that, Serene? What's going on?
I have a babysitting duty for a few days. I am currently babysitting Chelsea.
I see, but if you don't mind me asking, why are you babysitting Chelsea, sweetheart?
Bowser Jr. and Pom Pom are on a trip to New York City with Hatsune Miku. Bowser, Ice Princess, and Pom Pom's parents can't babysit Chelsea because they have other things to do. As for why Bowser Jr. and Pom Pom trust me to take care of Chelsea, it's because of how much I care for my minions, my brother, and my pets. I accepted the babysitting duty and decided to leave my brother in charge of our home kingdom until I come back.
I understand. Well, even though I originally planned on going to a movie theater with you to see the Super Mario Bros. Movie today, but I suppose I'm willing to change plans. Due to you babysitting Chelsea, do you think you can bring her to the movie theater to see the movie with us? And would you like for me to help you with the babysitting duty?
Well, since the Super Mario Bros. Movie is rated PG, I think I can allow Chelsea to see the movie, so I'll bring her to the movie theater to see the movie if she wants to go. And I believe I have the babysitting duty under control, so you don't need to help me babysit Chelsea. I wouldn't want Bowser Jr. and Pom Pom to lose a lot of money anyway. I will see you at the movie theater after I am finished washing the dishes, Hanzo.
All right. I'll see you at the movie theater, my love.
All right, Chelsea. I have finished washing the dishes. But before I started washing the dishes, I received a call from Hanzo the Bullet Train. He said that he wants me to take you to the movie theater to see the Super Mario Bros. Movie. You've been wanting to see that movie, right?
Yes, I've been wanting to see that movie for so long. And now, I finally have the chance to see that movie.
In that case, I hope you will enjoy watching the movie when we get to the movie theater. Anyways, it's time to go. Hold on to me, Chelsea. I'll teleport us to the movie theater. All right, Hanzo, we're here. Are you ready to see the Super Mario Bros. Movie with us?
I am ready to see the movie with you. Let's go inside the movie theater.
Hello there and welcome to the Regal Cinemas Stadium. What movie would you three like to see?
Hi. All three of us would like a ticket to see the Super Mario Bros. Movie.
Okay. But would you like to have anything else to eat or drink?
Yes. We all will have medium-sized popcorn and a cup of water.
And would you like to have butter on your popcorn?
No thanks. That's all we would like.
Very well. All of that will cost you $40. Thank you for the money. Here are your tickets. Now, please wait until your popcorn and water are ready.
Well, Serene and Chelsea, what was your opinion on the movie we just watched? In my opinion, it was good, and my favorite part was when Mario and Luigi defeated Bowser.
I liked it. The battle in the movie was very cool. I'm giving this movie a 10 out of 10.
Same here.
I'm glad that we all enjoyed the movie. Oh, and Serene. Maybe we should go on more dates together. I enjoyed every second of spending time with you. I wish you good luck while you are babysitting Chelsea. And to you, Chelsea, I hope you will remember to behave yourself while my girlfriend is babysitting you while your parents are away.
Yeah, we should definitely spend more time together, Hanzo. And while I'm doing okay with babysitting Chelsea, I'll try to take good care of her while her parents are gone. Anyways, Chelsea, now is the time to head back to your house. We need to eat dinner and go to sleep after that.
Okay, Serene. This is perfect. Now that it's nighttime, I'm in the mood to do another prank on my babysitter. But first, I need to get something from the bathroom. Good. My babysitter is still sleeping in my parents' bedroom. Now I'm going to perform this prank and see her reaction when she wakes up.
When you're feeling lonely, lost and let down, seems like those dark skies are following you around. And life's just one big shade of gray. You wonder if you'll see the light of day behind the clouds.
What a lovely morning. I think it's time my babysitter finds out about the prank I pulled on her and see her reaction.
Leave me even though you can't quite make it out. You may not see.
Good morning, Chelsea. How are you doing today?
But there's a big blue sky waiting right behind the clouds.
Chelsea, what's so funny? Why are you laughing at me?
Oh, Serene, you should go to one of the bathrooms and look at yourself. You have something on your face.
Wait, what the heck? Why is there makeup on me? Chelsea, you better get over here right now. You have tons of explaining to do on why there is makeup on my face.
Oh my gosh, look at yourself, Serene. You with makeup? This has got to be one of the funniest things I've ever seen.
Oh my gosh, Chelsea. Please stop laughing at the fact that I have makeup on me and just explain why my face is like this. You better tell me the truth, or I'm calling your parents. I said stop laughing at me having makeup on my face, Chelsea. Tell me why I have makeup on my face, or else I'm calling your parents about this.
Okay, Serene. Here's why you have makeup on your face. The reason why your face is covered in makeup is because I put makeup on your face during the night while you were sleeping. I thought that it would be funny for me to put my mom's makeup on your face while you were sleeping. Serene, I did this as a prank. I thought that you like wearing makeup.
And where did you get that I like wearing makeup, Chelsea? First off, I don't like wearing makeup at all because it makes me feel as if I'm not being myself. I did not willingly wear makeup in my life. I can tolerate others wearing makeup, but when it comes to someone putting makeup on me, I get very annoyed. Larity and I are still friends, but there was a time when Larity did put makeup on me, and I was not happy with how I looked with makeup on my face. Listen, I'll keep this makeup on for the rest of the day, but I'm still disappointed in you for doing this to me while I was sleeping. I just hope I won't get humiliated in public.
Okay, Serene. I'm so sorry for putting makeup on you while you were sleeping. I just thought that it would be a prank and that you would like it. I didn't know that you hate makeup.
It's fine, Chelsea. But let's just go to McDonald's for breakfast.
Oh my gosh. I like the makeup on your face, Serene Basil. It seems as if you changed your opinion on makeup after all. You should wear makeup more often. Ha 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 ha.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. As if I needed this in the first place. First off, Rainbow Dash, stop laughing at the fact that I have makeup on my face. Chelsea, who is behind me, put her mom's makeup on my face as a prank while I was asleep. And second, even though I'll put up with this makeup on my face for the rest of today, I still don't like wearing makeup at all because it makes me feel uncomfortable. Can you let us place our orders now, Rainbow Dash?
Okay, first of all, Serene, I was only joking around. It is very unlike you to wear makeup, and the fact that you are wearing makeup right now feels somewhat strange to me. But I had no idea that Chelsea decided to put makeup on you while you were still sleeping. However, there's no need for you to lose your temper over this. Speaking of Chelsea, what is she doing here with you?
I'm sorry, Rainbow Dash. I just don't like getting reminded of the time Rarity put makeup on me and other characters laughing at me for that. That just pisses me off.
And the reason why I am with Serene Basil right now is because she is my babysitter for the time being. My parents have gone off on a trip to New York City with Hatsune Miku. They will be coming back in a few days. So far, Serene has been doing a good job on taking care of me. I just didn't know that your friend here doesn't like wearing makeup at all.
Oh, I see. Well, I'm glad that Serene is doing good in taking care of you while your parents are gone, Chelsea. But here's a lesson that I hope you've learned by now, Chelsea. You don't ever steal your mom's makeup to put it on someone else when they don't like wearing makeup. Maybe it's true that you didn't know that Serene Basil doesn't like wearing makeup, but now you do. And I hope that Serene doesn't get humiliated in public just because of that.
I understand now. I'm so sorry about all of this.
It's okay. Just don't do this again.
Anyways, we're going to go ahead and place our orders. I would like to have a sausage egg biscuit, please.
And I would like to have a McChicken biscuit, please.
Okay, Serene and Chelsea. That's going to cost you $6. Just to let you know, your order is going to be here in a few minutes, so you'll have to wait.
So, Chelsea, you wanted to train here with me just so you could increase your fighting skills and your magic skills.
Yes, I do.
Okay, but just so you know, even though both of us have super forms, we will remain in our base forms for the entirety of this training session. Oh, and before this training session starts, I'll give you a handicap. If you can land a single blow against me, then the training session will end, and I'll declare you the winner. How does that sound, Chelsea?
That sounds good to me, Serene. I can't wait to be the winner of this training session, but enough talk. It's time for this training session to start.
So, Serene, how well did Chelsea behave while she was under your care while Pom Pom and I were on a trip to New York City?
Well, overall, she was a good girl while I was babysitting her. I tried the best I could to take care of her and make her happy. But here are some other things she did. First, she tried to prank me by putting a teddy bear on the top of the front door all because I was a little late when I arrived at your house. Second, she slammed a pie into my face while we were playing hide and seek, which caused me to go to the bathroom and wipe my face. And third, Pom Pom, your daughter stole your makeup just so that she could put it on me even though I don't like wearing makeup. I almost got humiliated in public after that.
Wait, what? Chelsea, why would you think that it's a good idea to steal my makeup just so you could put it on someone who doesn't like it? This behavior is not very good at all.
Oh, and before I forget, there is one question that I need to ask the both of you.
And what question would that be, Serene Basil?
How could you buy the South Park, the Fractured But Whole game for Chelsea? I discovered that Chelsea has that game for the Nintendo Switch, but she's too young to play the game. Why did you buy that game for her?
Okay, I admit it. I bought the South Park, the Fractured But Whole for Chelsea because Dark Bowser actually forced me to buy the game for her. After that, Dark Bowser actually forced Chelsea to play the game several times. I'm very sorry about all of this, Serene.
Well, okay. That makes sense. However, in case if Dark Bowser is to come back here and force your daughter to play the South Park, the Fractured But Whole game again, you may need to throw that game in the trash. Anyways, as I announced before, Chelsea's overall behavior while I was babysitting her was that it was mostly good, so I'll be willing to babysit her again if I'm not busy.
We're glad to hear that. We'll be sure to give Chelsea a reward for her good behavior while she was with you. Here's the money we have for you since you took good care of her.
Thank you for the money, Bowser Jr. and Pom Pom. Now if you'll excuse me, it's about time for the Queen to return to her home kingdom. I'll see you all whenever I see you. Goodbye.
Well, Chelsea, since you behaved while we were in New York City and Serene Basil was babysitting you, we'll give you a reward. We're taking you to Dave and Buster's. Now, let's go.